what the project was. This is Surfy. Now today I'm going to talk about an article that came in the Sunday Greener. And it's talking about the fact that basically bureaucracy, right, is what really prevent security forces, right, from clamping down on this phone thing and people are use phone to send out hits. And what gives this article extra level of credibility is that the CTAC boss was interviewed, right? So somebody who should know what go on, somebody who does this on a day-to-day basis, right, can give them opinion. It's really interesting. I'm going to have to read it and show them just how much of a joke Jamaica's system is. But before we go any further, I just want to send a special patron birthday shout out to Okino. Hope you enjoy your special day, right? And I wish you many, many more, right? Remember, health is wealth, right? So live long and prosper. Big up yourself. Now let me get straight into this article. Because when I read it, my fellows have scratched my head. See, I want thing for hear me come on this platform and say certain things, right? You might think to yourself, oh, he's just ranting, he don't know nothing, he just talk extreme, right? He just want use a lot of hyperbole because he want get views, right? You know, simple Simon's theory. But when the CTAC boss come out and say it, I wonder if no people eyes are open. You see, this article and this video is not centered around how the man them get the phone in the prison, because where there's a will, there's a way. And 87 would hide phone in a food, hide phone in a shoes, hide phone anywhere them can. They might get cooked water for bring it in, all kind of ways. But what happened when them get catch with it? That's one thing I've always wondered, the legal side to it. Because if the phone get taken, but what happened when the phone get taken? Well, I'm glad the CTAC boss come out, right? And in my opinion, this is a subtle call out, right? Superintendent Anthony McLaughlin, this is a subtle call out. He come out and he attack the government, right? But he might do a subtle call out. I like it. I'm going to tell you why I say that. He's saying, enough time to do investigations, then end up find out that the person who put out the hit, that prison. That won't surprise anybody over here, right? We know them things go on constantly. But this is what stands out to me. I'm actually have put it on the screen because I'm wanting to read it for myself. These are not my opinions, this is not my theory. This is what the boss at CTAC has said. Right? You see, even after them get the phone them from some down in a jail, however. As it stands right now, security forces can't do much with it. Because you think to yourself, well, and then if the phone has sent out all kind of hits, then maybe the phone have on messages and all them things, then you can probably run this and take this off. Right? As it stands, the government can't do much with it. As it stands, them can just take the prisoner's phone, right? Well, I put out the hit. And then get this and then go and quote it. A matter of fact, see the pain screen. It was also not clear what is done with cell phones, see some inmates. Or whether some 50 phones uncovered in a recent operation at the Spanish Town Adult Correctional Center in St. Catherine, according to Minister Without Portfolio, Matthew Samuda, two weeks ago, have been featured in any criminal investigation. So they don't know one to phone them, and they don't know if the phone them even are no part of the investigation. So the really important part there. But even if they were, meaning even if they were a part of the criminal investigation, the issue that exists now is that there is no criminal offense under the Corrections Act that covers cell phones. So we just use the provision under common law and treat it, meaning the cell phones, as a broad contraband. I wonder if you realize what that means. In Jamaica's correctional system, there is no criminal offense specifically targeting people who use cell phone, mushers use cell phone and put out hits. is that them people are really worried about the people who have put out hits. There is no criminal offense. They must just charge them as just a contraband. So no wonder people like Bribri and them, no care much time them get featured, and no much time people going to take a phone from them, man, just to get a next one, because you know what? We can just keep put out my hits, because even if you take away the phone with me, you can't use it none. Even if I send a voice note or I send this, send a text message, and even if the message still on the phone, you can't take the phone and use it for an investigation and go in a court of law and sink me. Them know that. Them know that these criminals are the best lawyers money can buy, and them lawyers them probably advise them about the law. Them can't do nothing. There is no criminal offense in 2021. In 2000, when Jamaica been having this problem with Dan in a jail and sending orders to man from Wapikil Fellow, in 2021 there is no criminal offense that covers cell phones. How long no cell phone invented? Look like a last month. So you government need some time, because you know, a last month invented. We just want to see some of the favorite leaders then. Going, how far back in the wango? How much years in the wango back? Who your favorite leader? Who your favorite prime minister? Who your favorite party? Much end in the power when time when I use phone and send you out orders. I know in 2021, there is no criminal offense. No, it makes sense. This is why I love this interview. This is why I'm glad the CTAC boss come out himself and say it, because the man will know. He goes on to state, noting that this alternative is often frowned upon by the courts, especially where gang affiliation and criminal conspiracy must be established explicitly. In other words, this not going to win a court. So you're going to charge a man with a broad contraband with a cell phone, and I'm going to say in a court, it's frowned upon. Judge say, yeah, what that? This can't work. I joked in that. Move this in front of me. You know, in a case. You know, because there's nothing specific that says a man shouldn't be in. If you're in a prison and you use phone and this and that, then you violate Section 2, Article 5. That it doesn't exist. So when they got a court and you just charge man for just contraband and you use on phone and you run a, you mean a cleanse and you mean a try. Judge a throw that out because the law doesn't back it. This is why your favorite 87, your favorite 90 behave like this in a jail, because they know the system is pathetic. The laws are weak. Now it all makes sense. This is how the Jamaican government for decades now have been getting outsmart by criminals. But let me tell you this, is either them can't do it or them not want to do it. You think it's because, or you think all these highly educated politicians, many of whom are lawyers themselves, you think say them just all, oh no, these 90s, these criminals in jail just keep beating us, then keep outsmarting us, is because there's no motivation. You think them don't know the law weak? We'll get to that anyway. You think for the last 10, 15, 20 years, them don't realize that something is wrong with the law? Why them not fix it? Because they care about people, right? All your favorite leaders in the last 20, however long, cell phone get popular. All your favorite leaders would clearly she say the law week, why them never fix it then? I go show in our next quote. When me tell you this article, you have to read it for yourself. It's on Jamaica Gleaner. Listen to this next quote. This is from Matthew Samuda. Are you ready for this? The legislation is archaic and colonial, and we have to change that and bring it to the parliament very soon. When you hear me say that all the time, so the law them in Jamaica outdated, enough of them have come from colonial days when they never have to deal with this issue, right? So you find that you can't use old laws to fight new criminals, because the old laws were not written right, for deal with nothing like Klansman or the Stone Crusher or nothing like that. Right. When them laws that get written, them will deal with one and two man down the road. Right. So those legislators never did write laws for deal with them write laws for deal with the criminals of their time and for them era. We're living in a different era. Right? We're dealing with a different type of monster. So we need different type of laws. So ask yourself this question. Why politicians are going to look upon you in 2021 until they say, I'm going to bring it to parliament very soon. Soon, you know. And that's Jamaican soon. You know? When I say Jamaican soon, can mean 5 years. You know? When a Jamaican say soon link here, you don't know when that will be. You know? Because I'm really, when I say Jamaica have 8 days. You know? Jamaica have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Sunday. Right? And Sunday can be any day. Bring to the parliament very soon in 2021. How many different administrations do you see in the last 20 years? How many different prime ministers and ministers of national security? And I know the man they must say they're going to bring to parliament very soon. Now you see why me can't stop say. It's either them can do it or them not want to do it, or we know them can do it. So that means them never want to do it. Because see them and say them are going to do it now. Because parliament can do it. Parliament can bring the laws. Even they want, parliament could have bring it in. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40 years ago. And a long time phone has sent out orders from prison, it's just that the method, because obviously now we have WhatsApp and everything there, but even before that, man used to make them call and send out them texts or whatever. Even if it means writing on paper, or the same thing, getting messages from outside the jail to the streets. So now you understand why the title, right, of the piece in the Gleaner is that bureaucratic bungling hinders efforts to link phones seized behind bars. Because after you take out the phone, for example, you say this person, for example, a brebe, I send out how much it's. After you get him phone, you need the legislation fibs, alright, can get this and get this and get this. It almost seem like, say, somebody who they are road can come under greater scrutiny because you cannot get warrant and search the phone and get this off of the phone. Government can lock you up, police can lock you up, get your phone, get a warrant and go through phone and take off and take off. But the man who dead behind bars, right, who actually have put out the hit them, right, constantly, you would think it'd be easy for us to take the phone and go. This might be a common sense approach. Me understand say, obviously I'm no lawyer, but this is how me see it. If a man got jail as a done, and then we hear say, he must send out hits from people in the street, and you search him, sell and find him phone, that phone is automatically being lodged into evidence, and anything with the pan it is fair game, because you're not supposed to have it in the first place. I can understand civilians, I can understand that you need warrant and just cause go through civilian phone, because the government is supposed to just dig up any civilian phone them feel like. But if them get intelligence and them start build a case against a man, then obviously yes, they can go get warrant and search. When them lock you up, they can go search phone and all them thing they. Fine. But Dana jail should be a case, you know what, just take away phone and look where night. Kind of you have it in the first place. The fact is a contraband means what kind of you know the rights are get violated. People that are rude afford about right to get violated, but you don't have no phone in the first place. So pass the phone, make you see what you are saying. That's what a serious government would do. That's what serious leaders would do. Yeah. Are the people them setting their papers, you know? It frowned upon in court. Judges say, oh, this is not law. So why them can't bring in the law? Say, once you catch up with the phone, want to catch up with contraband, worse if you had done on him in the phone, I get search right through, and anything we see tonight is admissible in a court. We have built a case against, so even if you're in a court, even if you're in a jail already, fine, I get one next 30 years on top of where I get. This is why you see your favorite criminals in jail. Phone after phone, hit after hit, and you think to yourself then, how come them man are still, even though it's known that him a put out hit, why him keep having, because there is no repercussions. It's a slap on the wrist. They must get charged with basic contraband. I'm very happy that the CTAC boss come out and do this. Because people like them, people like Anthony McLaughlin, when them come out and say them things, because the people know say, well, he must know because he's in the field. It's a whole heap of weight. It's a whole heap of weight because remember, at 87 or 90, can I say, I fear anything, I will say, oh, don't listen to Serpico because in those bad men and I fight against me, so I make up things to get views. So, alright, that may be so, right, but what are you going to say about the boss of CTAC? He might try to get views though. When the bad man scam at him, I don't know. Hear the man say it. You want me to repeat it from finish the video? The man said, even if the phone them can be a part of criminal investigation, the issue exists now is that there is no criminal offense under Corrections Act in 2021. See, at the end of the day, Jamaican people get the country where we deserve. Because you can't call yourself a serious country when all these years, something like this, something that has been directly affecting people, affecting people's lives, affecting people's homes, making more people have a runway. And as a nation, we stood by idly while there's not even a piece of legislation to fight against it. And if, more I know what people are, what have people been voting for Jamaicans that care about them life? Because a year of life, they done might send for, you know. And it's still not enough motivation to make people put leaders under pressure. 5, 10, 15, no matter how far back you want to go. People won't put leaders under pressure. When you're not going to bring in some law, right, we can actually do something. Instead, every election, every campaign, it's run on gimmicks. Shoes, clothes, who have which horse, who have which car, complete rubbish. We have nothing to do with nothing. People get the country they deserve. See, when I talk like this, people get upset and then come in my DM. You can't say that. How dare you? What you think? Me did think, say, and me did like you wasting my time with all kind of rubbish messages in my DM. I said what I said and I meant what I said. It's not my fault you're not used to listening to an assertive male voice. Listening to all that mollycoddling and people tell you what you want to hear. That's nothing more than populism. Oh, we're the best. As a society, we're not doing anything wrong. Just because this, and just because that. No accountability. The people, they must get held accountable too. Leaders get held accountable, yes, but people put leaders in the power. The people have consistently back ministers of national security, prime ministers, this and that. People who couldn't even be bothered to put in one legislation to deal with something, right, that directly affect the lives of Jamaicans on a daily basis. But don't worry, they might put it before parliament soon. You can see when that soon is. People, I'm telling you, I'm charged. Charged because I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. I'm fed up of the excuses. I'm tired of the but. The lack of accountability, the lack of vision, the lack of doing even the basics. All me I wonder about is what kind of society we're gonna leave for the next generation. Who knows? Maybe them are gonna actually figure it out. because your favorite leaders can't deal with something as simple as this. And it's still not dealing with yet. I don't know how they're going to deal with the more complex issues, the things that them can't even see in front of them. Something so basic as a man, a done whether a jail, I still have no hits on phone. Them can't squash that. Somebody who can't even move, somebody who's stuck in a cell. Man, see, what am I going to deal with the man in my dark road? The elusive 90s, them don't even bother to talk about the 116s. Because we already know. Don't get your hopes up. Them can't deal with the brevity. They're going to deal with the 116. They're not on the legislation for dealing with the brevity. They're going to have legislation for dealing with the 116. Them can't track a barrel. Man, I tell you, so tracking a barrel is unrealistic. You think them are going to catch a 116? Or even it's a half decent 90? Anyway, HM Squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know. No life. Ultra Squad, stay circling. Bound to be some scrap somewhere. Bless.